in the 70s was that the real talent that had come through in the 60s died off or got married or drugged out or became bored, and the empty space on the charts was filled by the Division 2 talent that had been trying and failing and waiting. Paul Raven, the warm-up man for Ready, Steady, Go in the 60s, became Gary Glitter for the 70s. John's Children, a 60s flock group, turned into T-Rex. A couple of backing musicians for Long John Baldry became Elton John and Rod Stewart. A failed mime artist decided to be David Bowie. And where youthful musical ability and talent had dominated the 60s, marketing men took over the 70s. Chaz Chandler, the bass player with the Animals, magically changed into Chaz Chandler, who marketed and promoted Slade. Mickey Most, the singer from the 60s, produced Mudd, Susie Quattro, Hot Chocolate and others. And best of all, a singer, writer, producer from the 60s who'd had a few hits like Everyone's Gone to the Moon and It's Good News Week, a spotty Cambridge undergraduate, became super marketing man, Jonathan King. Not only did I merchandise myself with Una Paloma Blanca and Lucy Love and Sugar Sugar and It's the Same Old Song, do I hear applause? But I built super groups like the Piglets and St. Cecilia. Remember leaping down with your knickers in the air? Genesis and 10cc and the Bay City Rollers. It's not generally known that their first hit, Keep On Dancing, featured 13 vocals by Jonathan King and only one, Bay City Roller. Oh, the 70s were great fun, but glam rock was the product of clever marketing. Then along came punk.
String of hits in the 70s. Do you take what Jonathan says seriously?
Well, Jonathan, as usual, is talking out of his backside, as he always does.
Not you used to sing out of yours.
Well, what you failed to mention, Jonathan, was you still got to write great songs and make great records, so you're putting down all the people that bought those records.
Oh, no, but they were great records. You made some brilliant records.
You didn't say that, though.
Oh, but there were lots of great records in the 70s, but none of the styles were really huge stars. We've got to admit, no matter how
well... Elton John, yeah, and Rod Stewart, but compared, David Bowie, and Led Zeppelin,
yeah, but
weren't big stars.
Compared to megastars like Paul McCartney, they mean nothing.
Oh, you're ridiculous.
There were only rejects from the 60s anyway. Be honest.
Get away with it.
Hang on, let's get the other point of view. Bob Harris, your old grey whistle test, of course, was the authoritative voice of authentic rock in the period of the 70s. What's your view of Professor King's view?
Well, a lot of the seeds of the music that developed in the early part of the 70s were definitely sown in the 60s. There's no doubt about that. You know, as Jonathan was saying about people like Elton John, it's not that they were failed beforehand. They were more kind of learning their craft, I would say, and they happened to come into popularity in the early part of the 70s. But the early part of the 70s was also a very sort of fragmented time. There are lots of different styles of music coming through at that time. I mean, we seem to have moved further and further down the line and away from rock and roll. And rock and roll, to me, was always about sort of, I don't know, 1 minute, 50 seconds of absolute energy.
But that's what glam was about as well.
Yes,
glam was about,
well,
energy,
I mean,
and show business.
T-Rex, Slade, you know, you look back at those singles now and they're terrific singles. I mean, it's a funny thing that you know, you look back over the years and somehow all music from the 50s, the 60s, the 70s, the 80s, you know, as you look back on it, it gradually all melts together. In a sense, this program with all of us sitting here is an example of that, with the Bay City Rollers, with the Pistols, with Slade, with Mud, with the Damned, all featured on the same program. At the time, we probably wouldn't have been seen in the same television studio with one another, but you look back on things and records become either great records or not.
That's
you
true.
Either like them or you don't. And through the 70s, there were a fantastic number of really good records and punk.
None of Jonathan
in.
King's, I might add.